Are you tired of the typical libraries with conventional music that makes you feel meh? Introducing Lyrics.com, the music website made for and by minds like you. Our team are lifelong musicians and producers in love with music. Search the Lyrics music catalogs and find music with guaranteed originality. Mark the difference with Music of Signature at Lyrics.com.
I was alone and looking to gain someone to hold me, say I'm not a waste. Desperation had led me to be debased. Somehow you found me and saw I was prey, sunk in your teeth to have a small taste. Decided I was perfect to play out your game.
Perfect, definitely perfect voice. This is I Know What You Are by Autumn Skylar. We're so pleased to have her here with us. So, hi Skylar, how's it going?
Hi, doing great. Glad to be here. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely, our pleasure. Absolute pleasure. You know, your voice is so powerful and so wonderful. And the
Thank
message
you.
In these songs, we want to get to know you a little bit better. Why don't you introduce yourself and, you know, tell us a little bit about your music.
Sure. My name, as you said, I am Autumn Skylar. I am a singer-songwriter from New Jersey, and I have currently about 20 original songs that are not yet released professionally, but that is the step that I am looking forward to taking, hopefully before the end of the year. I typically write about fairly darker material, you know, traumatic experiences that happen sort of as a therapeutic expression, not only for myself, but I really hope with the music that it is able to help individuals that have gone through similar experiences feel less alone and have sort of an outlet for their own emotional responses.
Wonderful. I couldn't think of a better purpose. And this is what music does for a lot of songwriters and creators, as well as for their audience. You know, we have talked about this, you know, on the previous touch base with you. These transformation into from something that started like maybe a difficult situation in your life and the process to make it into something beautiful for yourself and for others. And you know, how is this process in your case? Does it take a long time? You know, is it spontaneous and you just how is it? Tell us a little bit of the details.
Yeah, of course. You know, it does vary song to song, but typically I get most of my motivation when these situations occur and I'm sort of at my lowest. Usually I will take very long hot showers just sort of to kind of decompress. And it happens within those moments, I just get like a flash of song lyrics. So then I'll have to like jump out of the shower, immediately start typing it down. And then sometimes within a day or two, I'll have a fully fleshed out song. I've tried before though to just go into songwriting without having that flash of inspiration. And it takes quite a greater amount of time to actually get a song created when I like go into it without having that little spark of inspiration that sort of comes out of nowhere. It's that spark that really ignites the whole process for me and sort of creates the song. It's very interesting for me how these lyrics, they'll just pop out of nowhere and then I'll write it down and then within like a few hours I'll have a fully fleshed out song.
Interesting. It's what they call, I think there's a term called the flash of genius. It's really powerful. So does it start with the lyrics? Does it start? Like, how the melody comes about in the music, the notes?
Yeah, honestly, when those lyrics pop into my head, the melody will start at the same exact time. So then it's just about sort of transposing what I'm hearing in my head into my preferred instrument at the moment, ukulele. So it takes a little bit of time to figure out, you know, what key this little melody I have going in my head is in, what chords. But after that, the process is really easy and the song almost writes itself at that point.
Beautiful. That's truthfully, you know, they call it the absolute ear for naturally talented individuals, musically talented. You know, like, I kinda envision this process for you. Like, you hear the song in your head, you just need to find it into reality, into your instrument. And you're mentioning that you know, your preferred instrument at the time is the ukulele. Do you play other instruments?
Yes, I also play guitar. So I did start out playing guitar about at 13. And then after a couple of years on guitar, I transferred over that musical knowledge to ukulele. I was playing both of them at the time, still favoring my guitar. But eventually, especially with some of the medical issues that I have, it just makes it easier for not only transportation, but when I am on stage performing, to use something that's lighter, like a ukulele, to perform. But also, I really love the dichotomy that comes with having such a happy-sounding instrument, such as a ukulele, and then darker words with it, because it's almost, you can, like, close your eyes and listen to the melody, listen to the song, and, you know, have a general positive vibe going. But then when you really listen into the lyrics and really hear what the song is about, it almost changes it, so you can have sort of these layers to the song. I think that it really adds some extra elements to it.
It definitely does. I think that's a very, very good point that you're making. You know, there's more depth into the, well, you know, at the end, that is kind of like the finding more interest, something more to explore, just not simple surface tension, right? So then, and this is what creates very good songs and very good albums, where those that you can keep on listening more and more, and the more you listen to them, the more you discover. And this is definitely one factor to it. You know, you mentioned you started with guitar. Do you, what are your influences? Like, you know, did you have anybody around you to show you music, to get you into it?
Yeah, so I grew up, both of my parents were always very musically inclinated. My mother, she was in All Shore Choir when she was in high school, and my father, he was in a metal band, you know, just when he was in his late teens, early 20s.
Nice.
And so I was always exposed to a large array of different musical genres, and it was always just a very musically oriented household. My father plays guitar, so I would always hear him just practicing or playing, and my mother singing in the kitchen while she's cooking. So it was always sort of influencing me, I think, probably even from the womb, you know, just having those musically oriented parents.
Beautiful. What type of, that's kind of interesting. You know, they're very far apart, you know, at least from the outside. So, musically, what do you have, any you know, any artist that you can inspire you, use as an example, you know, to start your own style?
Yeah, I mean, I always was exposed to a lot of different sorts of music, so some of those idolizations definitely came from a lot of different genres. I mean, Led Zeppelin, the Eagles, Queen was definitely some of the beginning ones. And then as I got older, Adele was gaining popularity probably around by the time that I was in middle school, I think was when I discovered her, when she was really beginning to hit the airwaves. Mm-hmm. So definitely was inspiring me from the get-go with that deep lyricism, and especially with the vocals that she's able to produce. It, I always aspired to be able to not copy her in any way, shape, or form, but to be able to have that power that she can produce behind the lyrics that she is singing. Because definitely there is a lot of beautiful lyricism throughout music, but you need to sort of have that power behind it to take it to that next level.
Definitely, absolutely agree. And you do it. You definitely got it. You know, you got a powerful voice and very...
Thank you.
Very educated. I don't know if you took lessons or is this natural?
I did do some lessons. So there was some guitar lessons as well as some vocal lessons for a couple of years. But eventually I hit a point where, not that I grew out of it, but just the vocal teacher that I had at the time, I was needing something more. And I haven't really looked into, especially with given like COVID and everything and the limitations that there are to musical teachers, specifically with singing, because, you know, you're not able to wear a mask for that. Mm. So I kind of have taken a break from any teachings for quite a while, but there was some influence and lessons that have helped me definitely in the beginning.
Yeah, at least, you know, like... this is perfect, but at least to being able to perform without destroying your vocal cords, you know, like, you know, breathing, the aspect of learning to breathe, and that's fundamental. So, well, wonderful, excellent. You have 20 songs at this point. What are you planning to do with them? You know, in, we know you want to like publish them professionally.
Yeah.
What kind of arrangement? What kind of collaboration? What do you want to do with your songs?
Yeah. So at this point, I am speaking with someone who I've done some work with. Background vocals on their own music productions, but we want to work towards the point of getting my own music out there, as well as having a fully fleshed out album, which I am in the works of, you know, getting the album down, working on some ideas for album artwork, and then just obviously picking which of my songs will go on it. So I want to take it to that next level and be able to put out this music on platforms, you know, such as Spotify, SoundCloud. I want it to reach a greater audience than it currently is. And then down the road, I do want to have other collaborations with different artists. I really love, especially, I don't know if it's like this everywhere with different music scenes, but specifically the one that I am obviously most accustomed to is the New Jersey scene. But everybody is so warm and welcoming and so desiring of those collaborations that I have always wanted to do. So I'm really hoping in the future something along those lines will be able to be produced and published, because I think that that would just be great. I've always wanted to work with somebody else and just create something together, to have two different viewpoints on one song.
Well, that's very open, and it's a you know, excellent point of view. You know, as you are following crows, and you know, people are gonna find you the same way we found you. Mm-hmm. If it was like, are you open to collaborate with other completely different music styles?
Oh yeah, 100%. My biggest goal, well, I don't know if it's the biggest, but definitely one of the ones that I've really been thinking about the most recently is I would love to have a collaboration with a rap artist to be able to have sort of like how I love that dichotomy that comes with playing the ukulele on a deeper song and a song with that deeper lyricism. I would love to be able to collaborate with someone with a completely different style of music and create something that is different, something that allows this beautiful merge of two different genres to create something unique that allows not only for the intended viewers, listeners to enjoy, but to hopefully open up the audience, you know, by having these two different genres connected together to open it up and maybe hopefully create something a little new. I mean, not that rap on a song is all that astonishing or revolutionary, but it would be awesome to have it sort of almost merged together, something along those lines. It's obviously still something that I'm thinking about and haven't fully fleshed out, but that's one of my biggest goals.
That would be definitely very, very cool to hear. You know, it could be really great, and not only from the musical aspect, but also, you know, the message to the audience in general, and also to the musician, to the music community, right, to the artist community. Mm. You know, that that capability to tend breaches, to create breaches and create something together when you are very different. And
yeah,
that's something that we definitely need, probably. You know, we can only wish you all the best. It's beautiful to meet talented artists like yourself with all their careers, in their view, and such an open mind, and you know, we go to definitely recommend everybody to follow and pay attention to Autumn Skylar. Beautiful person, beautiful voice, and you know, if you had a message for somebody, that who do you picture, you know, you picture somebody who would need to hear your songs, and what kind of message do you have for them?
Yeah, I would definitely say the audience that I'm trying to reach is definitely people that are struggling with whatever they might be struggling with, whether it's a really big struggle or a smaller one, someone that may necessarily not feel as though they're being heard by the people around them. I would just love to say that you are heard, you know, you're not alone. Life tends to test you and throw everything it has at you. And these are the building blocks of your life. And it may seem as though they're trying to push you down and suffocate you, but you really have to take the things that happen to you, and not that they happen for a reason, but to find meaning in them and to find a way to turn it around into something good and into something that can allow you to grow from the experience and become a better individual. That's the main thing. That's one of the main messages that I hope comes across in my music, is that awful things happen, but it's not because you're an awful person. It just means that you have to take the thing that happens to you and learn from it and grow from it and hopefully become a better version of yourself because of what happened.
Absolutely. I couldn't say it better. You know, be strong. You know, sometimes the most difficult things happen to the strongest. You need to find your strength inside of you. And this is beautiful. Autumn Skylar, it's been such a wonderful pleasure, and wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Keep doing what you're doing. Keep creating this beautiful music.
Thank you. I will. Thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate this. It was fantastic.
Our pleasure. All the best. And this is I Know What You Are by Autumn Skylar. Enjoy. Won't heal these mental scars. Say I was too sensitive. And I can't hear my thoughts. I can't erase your face. I told my story, paid the cost. Got it thrown back in my face. And I know what you are. I know what you did. You can run, but you won't get far. I'll never be over it.
Are you tired of the typical libraries with conventional music that makes you feel meh? Introducing Lyrics.com, the music website made for and by minds like you. Our team are lifelong musicians and producers in love with music. Search the Lyrics music catalogs and find music with guaranteed originality. Mark the difference with Music of Signature at lyrics.com.